Thank you. As you may have noticed, unlike many staffs on Capitol Hill, our staff doesn't look like a Head Start program. We have, I think, the best staff on Capitol Hill. Thank you all very, very much for doing a really great job. I tell constituents who come and thank me for what our staff has done for them, didn't you notice that thing over the door as you went in that says, the difficult we do immediately, the impossible takes a little longer. And that's what our miracle working ladies do. Almost, well, you have one man who does constituent services, but mostly ladies. Bud hurried over the name Tracy Leske pretty quickly in that introduction. Tracy is really the star here. I'll explain why, but we might not be here except for Tracy. Although somebody would have noticed it sooner or later, wouldn't they? It seemed to be pretty obvious, but nobody had noticed it until Tracy did. I was trying to turn my colleagues onto this on Capitol Hill to get some help in marshaling resources from EPA and USDA, and I went to my neighbor, Todd Platts, and I didn't have to work very hard to get him turned on to this because he had gone out to his picnic table and he opened up the umbrella and they fell out by the thousands, he said. So he knew that this was something that needed attention. I think it was early September last year, Sally Taylor from our staff went up to Bobby Black's orchard above Thurmont to see a problem that they had up there. And I was up, I think it was on the 8th day of September, and Tracy was there. And I was there about 20 minutes listening to what they were saying, and maybe it's because I'm a farmer and a scientist, it was immediately apparent to me what we were faced with here. You know, I frequently hope I'm wrong. I hoped that I was wrong about the energy crisis we were facing in oil, and I was a prophet for a number of years saying that we were going to reach peak oil in the world the way we did in the United States. I kept saying every night I go to bed, I pray I'm wrong. I wasn't wrong. We have reached peak oil. We now face a huge crisis in the world. And I hoped I was wrong about Haliomorphus hollis, the brown marmorated stink bug, because I wasn't there but about 20 minutes and I said, let me see if I understand what you're telling me. This is a bug. By the way, he hitchhiked in sometime in the mid-90s. We first found him in Allentown, Pennsylvania. I would gather by where he is most concentrated now that he is happy with somewhat warmer climes because the major concentration is not around Allentown, Pennsylvania. It's a bit further south here. He's in, 30-some states now we found him. He's a great hitchhiker. Sally saw him going down the road in the back of a Greyhound bus. So he hitchhikes easily from one place to another. So let me see if I understand what you're telling me. This is a bug that starts eating early in the spring. He eats for 6 months. He eats almost everything. Everything apparently has a thin skin and any amount of sugar inside, he's happy with it. He eats almost everything. Lays its egg in the bottom of the leaf. The young hatch in it look just like him. They're little miniatures of daddy and they come out and eat with him. And you know, you can't kill him with a residual spray because he eats from inside. And if you then use a contact spray and kill him, he's just back again the next day. And we've learned, by the way, that he may be back the next day because he responds to some of these things by detoxifying that thing in his body and maybe on the ground for a couple of days, and then later he's back on the tree. But even if he stays dead, his brothers come in from the neighboring because he is very agile. He flies. He's very mobile. He flies very easily. And I said then that this could be a plague of truly biblical proportion. It was Tracy who first made the identification between the blemishes on the apples that our people have been treating as a calcium deficiency for several years and dumping gypsum around their trees. She first identified that as a response to the stink bug. And apparently, it's a couple of weeks, Tracy, before the fact that he had fed there ends up in a blemish because he doesn't eat much. If they would just all of them come to one apple and eat, there's plenty of them there for him, but they don't do that. They go here and there and a bite or two on each apple, and everybody's looking for a perfect apple. I'm telling people, and that's a message we need to get out. You may need to eat apples that are less than perfect because I understand that we're opening up now some of our storages and 75% of some of the apples in storage. They had no defects when they put them in storage because the bug had just eaten. You don't see the defect when the bug is eaten. And the apple's still alive, by the way. If it weren't, it would be rotten. So the apple's still alive and living in that storage. And then the apple responds to that. We believe it's a yeast that is injected there. The apple responds to that with a little kind of a knot in there and a little dimple on the surface and some brown necrotic tissue around that in the apple. And I said then that this could be a plague of truly biblical proportions. Let's hope not. So we had the Department of Agriculture, all of the relevant parts of the Department of Agriculture and EPA come into our office, and I told them, this is not business as usual. We got to be in panic mode. Next spring is coming. Who knows what's going to happen? So all winter long, they've been collecting stink bugs. No problem finding enough of them. Understand, you go to the local lumber yard, lift up a few boards, and rake them off by the hundreds so you've got enough for your research. So they've been working all winter now, and we're going to see what they've come up with. But we face a huge challenge this year. But I would like to get the message. If I eat these apples, they're just f*** you. I'm an old farm boy. When I come to the blemish, I bite it off and spit it out. Isn't that what you do? So you may have to get used to having less than perfect fruit in the market. Thank you all very much for coming today. I'm really appreciative of all of our panelists who have come today to tell you what we have done, what we know, what we can do, and what the future hopefully looks like for the brown marmorated stink bug. I tried not to trivialize it. It's Haliomorphus hollis. Just calling it a stink bug, I think, kind of trivializes it. This is not a trivial problem, is it? Thank you again very much for coming.